I am here in St. Lucia as Secretary General. I'm making my first official visit to the Prime Minister and the government of St. Lucia, and having a very interesting conversation. The role of the Prime Minister of St. Lucia as the lead head for sustainable development in the community is a really important one. And at this time, as we are preparing for the COP27 that takes place towards the end of this year, as we take into consideration all of the important aspects of climate change, the impact of climate change on our economies, our societies, our production, particularly the agricultural sector, the role of St. Lucia in leading the discussion on sustainable development issues is really very important. So that's one of the first line items on my agenda here in St. Lucia, to have that conversation and to ensure that it is very clear that the Secretariat is providing as much support as we can and helping to organize the community, along with the other institutions that work with the community on climate and on climate financing and all of those things. So that's the first. And of course, the state of affairs post-COVID, as we call it, the impact of the protocols that we had to have in place to manage infections, which resulted in not only the economies closing, but schools, the impact that has had on our community's children here in St. Lucia and in the rest of the Caribbean. So that's another item on the agenda that we're discussing. I know that there's been a lot of work done here on returning to school and treating with some of the other issues to help make up the time lost in education across our region. So those are two important things that we're talking about. The other major thing on our agenda at this time is a matter of agriculture and food and nutrition. One of the side effects of COVID again was the threat to our food security, when the logistical arrangements, the shipping lanes, the availability of containers to bring food into the country. And so when the heads met around that issue early in the pandemic, it was clear that food security has to be a major first line priority in the community. So there's a big expo, agri food expo and forum that's taking place in Guyana on the 19th to the 21st of May, that's bringing together producers of food, meaning the farmers, the agricultural enterprises, the manufacturers, meaning the agro-processors, the commercial enterprises, the investors, in order to be able to implement projects on the ground that will result in increased food production and security in our region, food security, and of course, nutrition security, because one of the side effects of importing so much of our food is that we're also importing lots of salt and fat and preservatives, and that makes food less healthy than fresh food. And so it's to increase agricultural production, but also to enhance nutrition security as well. And so we're looking forward to that. We're looking forward to participation by private sector companies, by international companies, by governments across the region. And some heads are going to be coming to Guyana for that big event that we're hosting along with the government of Guyana on the 19th to the 21st of May. My personal dream.